Siguro tutugali. This is practice actually which I just knew that kung ako the presidential takeoff or landing may 30 minutes hiatus, so nobody takes off or land if the presidential plane is wala namang presidential plane na. But I want this stop. We should not be treated different from the other suffering Filipino passengers. Makita na ito crowded. At dagdagan mo ng mga ganong 30-30, like before it's even an hour, before you can use the skies. Mahirap ba yung ganon? It's not good. Siguro si Artur just advise the CAAP na any one of us, kung bigyan tayo ng priority to take off, salamat tayo, but we should also follow everyone's travel, pila tayo. Kasi yung ganon, for example, if I plan to fly at 5 o'clock, tapos yung mga aeroplano sa airports na walang night capability, and they would run out of daylight while waiting for the 30 minutes for the president to mamakansilar yung flight nila. So, and it is every other airport ma-delaying. And that would, you know, pagkatapos niyan, another crowded skies. Ako naman, not because of anything, pero ayaw ko magpa-importante na ganun. We should treat ourselves just like any other Filipino traveling. Wala man tayong aeroplano, but I plan to take the ordinary commercial flights. But not now because everybody is offering for the use of their airplanes. Kala siguro nila, bibili ako. Yung jet, kasi sabi ko yung lahat ng planes, I'm turning it over to the military. Pati yung mga assets ng yung Pangulo, gawin na natin hospital yan or put it to good use rather than allow it to rust to death. Ayun lang. Ang second is I forgot. Mayroon ako kasing sabihin sa... Anyway, ano ba ang... But I'd like sa Bong to... What are the urgent matters to be taken up? May agenda ka ba?
It's about the disaster
preparedness. Si Halad. You know, before you begin to talk, alam mo sir, ganito yan eh, General. Kasi I was born in Leyte. So day two, sinabi ko kay Bong, because the communications were cut, sabi ko kay Bong, gamitin mo ang army. Mayroon talaga yun silang a way of communicating. Pasa-pasa lang relay. But nung nalaman ko nga, nung nag-usap kami ng sundalo, sabi ko, kumusta? So, andyan, sabi niya, sir, bagsak yung Leyte. Tapos sinabi ko, anong klaseng bagsak? Sabi niya, sir, tumba lahat. Hindi ko naintindihan, sabi ko, tumba ang lahat bahay. Sir, pati kahoy. Ilan ang patay? Sabi niya, sir, mga mukhang mga aabot ito ng 10,000 estimate namin. Hindi ako makapaniwala. So that following, that evening, I mobilized the 911 of Davao City. Nag-assemble ako ng 10 doctors, 10 nurses. And pinuno ko ng antibiotics, tetanus, all of the things that we needed really of a victim in a calamity. They traveled, so nag-helicopter ako. But at yung sa Tacloban Bay, wala akong nakita isang rubber boat ng Navy. So, sabi ko sana, by this time mayroon na yan. At least the fast craft, mga frigate ng there is one. Andiyan na yung tanker. Alam mo bakit? What really surprised me. Bewildered me. Kasi nung pagbaba ko, hawak-hawak kong yung plastic na bottle. Sinalubong ako ng sundalo, sabi niya, Mayor, may tubig pa kayo. Alam ko na problema na. Kasi ano niyan, pagkain pati tubig, yung pagkain na hindi na nga niluluto. Yung diretso na from the can, masadenas ka o ma Cardin Ortega. And to think that about Ormoc was just a few kilometers, hindi naman few na few, but almost like 80. And Maasin was doing all right. Bakit walang tulong dito? And after 2 days, nagpalit ako ng personnel. Sabi ko, they can only endure it 2 days. Ang baho eh. Pati walang tubig. So I was expecting that there was an... I am not trying to condemn anybody. But nung tumawag ako yung there was a changing of personnel sa 911 sa Davao City, nagpadala ako ng mabago para pauwiin yung initial batch. Sabi ko, may tanker na ba dyan? Sabi, wala. Bakit sa ano? Saan yung mga tanker na Cebu? Marami kang makuha. Well, anyway, I'm not condemning anybody. But sorry, John Hallard lang, sir. You might want to take that into factor in you. Kasi dapat nakaposisyon yan sa nearest. Not really so near to be hit also, but by the typhoon or cyclone, if you may. Yun ang ano niya. So, the resources must be on deck, positioned nearby. If you can draw the path of the typhoon and deploy the assets of government, basta ano dyan, ano, tubig na malinis, pati pagkain na walang cooking dyan. Yung magpadala ka ng sakong bigas, ganon, on the first 1 week, it's useless. Ayan nga, si Juno. Yung sa, yung earthquake niya sa, Bol. Wala talagang kwenta. Una-una, wala silang lutuan. Walang parwood, wala lahat. Puro talagang pag-instant yan. Noodles, well, it is not nutritious really. It's a pure carbohydrates, but wala mga protein yan. But still, it can fill the stomach for the day. Yan ang ano ko lang, sir. We have a disaster maybe coming our way. Hopefully not, but... this planet is being, I don't know, punished by God. So every now and then, but everywhere, climate change is here. We were warm so many years ago, about 7, that ngayon, dumating na talaga. Even the United States is suffering heat wave on the western side. And this, dito sa, I can understand why the foreign secretary came home to escape the rigors of, so I'm through. Sir, salamat.
Yes, sir, we will learn from that experience. We should learn from that experience, sir. And before I start, sir, I would like to tell that I read in the papers that 2015 was the hottest so far completed year in the Earth in the first 4 months of 2016 were hotter than the first 4 months of 2015. So, meaning that indeed global warming is here. So, allow me to start now. His Excellency President Rodrigo Duterte, esteemed members of the cabinet, ladies. Yes, yes. Esteemed cabinet secretaries, ladies and gentlemen, good afternoon. This is to briefly apprise the president and his, the mayor and his cabinet on the status of our MDRM system, or disaster risk reduction and management, and our present possible ways ahead to level up our collective efforts on DRRM, especially at this critical time when rainy season sets in and we are on La Nina watch status according to our weather bureau, PAGASA. Here is the brief background on the DRRM institutionalization and system in the country. Republic Act 10121, known as the Philippine Disaster Risk Reduction and Management Act of 2010, was passed in May 27, 2010, repealing the then Presidential Decree 1566. The paradigm shift was basically from a reactive paradigm under the PD 1566 and NDCC setup to a proactive one under RA 10121 and the National Disaster Risk Reduction Management Council setup. To complement RA 10121, a new framework was developed to serve as a conceptual guide to implement activities across all sectors. Working within the four thematic areas of prevention and mitigation, preparedness, response and recovery, and rehabilitation. It allows for the whole of government and whole of society approach in the pursuit of its vision for a safer, adaptive, and resilient Filipino communities towards sustainable development. To achieve this vision, the National DRRM Plan for 2011 to 2028 was formulated and approved. The plan outlines programs, projects, and activities covering the four thematic areas aimed at strengthening the capacity of both national government and local government units, together with stakeholders, to build disaster-resilient communities and to institutionalize arrangements and measures for reducing disaster risks. The law also allowed for a more robust structure for DRRM, with the Secretary of National Defense as chairperson of the council. He is assisted by four vice chairpersons who are also the lead in each of the thematic area. We have the Secretary of DOST as vice chair for prevention and mitigation, the Secretary of DILG as the vice chair for preparedness, the Secretary of Social Welfare and Development for response, and the Director General of NEDA as the Vice Chair for Recovery and Rehabilitation. The 44 members of the Council include four civil society organizations and one from the private sector. Currently, the private sector is represented in the Council by the Corporate Network for Disaster Response. These members bear the responsibility of implementing the DRRM programs and projects as articulated in the National Disaster Risk Reduction Management Program. Given the foregoing and focusing on the four thematic areas, a lot has been done on DRRM, but they need to be sustained and improved on. In the immediate and short term, the following are the recommended to be given at most priorities. On prevention and mitigation, vice chaired by DOST, the completion of risk assessments for the whole country,
with focus priority on eastern seaboard and major river basin, which are most prone to flooding and negative effects of typhoons. Early warning system must be strengthened and sustained to affect LGU's right response actions. Flood control projects must also be completed the soonest possible time. Earthquake preparedness audit must also be done. On preparedness, vice chaired by DILG, conduct of continuous information, education, and communication campaign and capacity building. Preparedness efforts in consideration of the capacity of the concerned LGU should be stepped up. Continuous provision of equipage for response units, as well as establishment of needed facilities for prepositioning of response assets should be done. On response, vice chaired by DSWD, enhancement of the National Disaster Response Plan for hydrometeorological hazards and completion of NDRP for earthquake and tsunami hazards. These plans are among the actions, protocols, and programs that we have to proactively deal with. All are anchored in scientific information and thorough analysis of exposure and vulnerabilities of specific areas. On recovery and rehabilitation, vice chaired by NEDA, immediate restoration and improvement of the facilities, livelihood, and living conditions of disaster-affected communities. We need to adhere to the Build Back Better principle in recovery and rehabilitation. BBB is not restricted to the field of infrastructure and buildings. Rather, it is a step to building greater resilience across the various sectors of the affected areas, including social, economic, physical, and institutional. On possible ways forward, there is now a need to protect the livelihoods of the people, leading to having resilient communities. Thus, we need the cooperation and partnership of the private and business sector. This is one amongst the possible ways forward and critical milestones for this new administration. The partnership becomes an imperative for a successful DRRM program to protect our people's livelihood. We can encourage the private sector that together we can pursue undertakings in the following areas: economic risk assessment, business operations continuity, sustainable livelihood, disaster risk financing, logistics and supply chain, communications and infrastructure, and health and safety shelter. Currently, RA10121, or the Philippine Disaster Risk Reduction Management Law, is scheduled to undergo a sunset review. This offers a big opportunity for all of us to review and address the areas needing revisions to further strengthen the law and improve it. My predecessor initiated a review, and the recommendation was submitted to the Council last June 16, 2016. But needless to say, they ran out of time. So it's now my priority to review what they have started and pass it to the Council for their approval and endorsement to Congress. We presently have a fundamentally sound and arguably one of the best DRRM law and system in the world, in spite of its perceived and real shortcomings. However, this sunset review also presents a significant opportunity to improve our DRRM law and consequently the system. In the immediate short term, La Nina and typhoon season preparations must be geared up at all levels, from national government agencies to local government units level. This is to ensure the safety of our communities as well as to protect their livelihoods. On the La Nina preparations, this was presented, sir, during the last council meeting last June 16. Hazards mapping has been completed by DNR. DILG and OCD, my office, has issued directives to LGUs and regional Disaster Risk Reduction Management Council, respectively, on plan preparation for rainy season. Flood control projects of MMDA and DPWH are nearing completion. Slope protection projects are ongoing. Cleaning of drains and clearing of waterways are ongoing, as well as pruning of trees on major thoroughfares in Metro Manila has been started. Continuous capacity building programs on contingency planning, incident command system, preparedness planning have been conducted by OCD, DepEd, and DILG. Procurement of necessary supply of medicines and vaccines for vector-borne and water diseases, influenza, and respiratory tract infections are currently undertaken by DOH. Prepositioning of food and non-food items by DSWD and OCD, and response assets at the regional and local levels. Next slide. Before I end, I would like to inform everybody that we are now observing the National Disaster Consciousness Month starting tomorrow, sir. And this will be launched by all agencies, implementing agencies. So that ends my briefing. Good afternoon, sir.
Thank you, sir. Kung wala ka ng ibang isingit, kasi meron ako dito na I am setting up a complaint office 24 hours, manned by 10 operators covering the entire country. The number will be 8888. And they can report to me any complaint. And there will be a manager who will redirect their complaints to the proper office. So kung malalaman ko dito, kung yung bumbero doon is working. And ang policies ko from here on would bind local governments. The line of processing lahat ng papel, yung 1 month, minimum of 3 to 5 signatures if can be helped. Tapos yung, I do not want to see the Filipino queuing, lining up. If there's a particular office or agency, they should be given a shopping list if they are ignorant or does not know anything. Then after completion, they would go there to submit the application or clearance. And they should be given a stub, laminated, at the expense of government. And they can insert the day and the date where he could go back. Gusto ko sa acceptance ng mga applicants, it should be, there must be a ledger. And it would be signed by both the receiving clerk and the applicant or the person having transaction with government. Tapos doon sa, she can then now use the computer to assess the workload of the office. And after that, she is given the notice there, be back on next month at this hour, on this day, and you will have it. Ibibigay lang niya yun. So there will be no lining up. At dito sa, same dito sa, I don't know, I'm still trying to figure out how it would unfold. But I'm planning to have, I will papayag si Bebo to set up another department for overseas workers only. And where they can find, or if they both can make it an agency as effective, wala mo nang problema dyan. Pero solely for overseas workers. And I would like to direct the NBI, the BIR, and the police there, may booth sila. And total, may computer naman pala di gamitin. And the workers there, if not on the same building, at least in a contiguous place, but they would not have to travel, spend so much. Walking distance, maghanap tayo. At kung magpunta, sabi niya, he's an up, sa, applying for a certain job. He should start with any of the, anong makuha niya. If its name is statistics, there must be an office there. Para isang lakaran na lang siya. And he's given a shopping list, but kung maaari lang, kagawawang Pilipino talaga. Sakay dito, sakay doon ilang araw yan. No? Wala naman nangyayari. He should only travel if you block, a block or same building. Makuha niya lahat without any really having to endure the bureaucratic inutility. So, that is really to protect. I am bent to protect the young. The young people going out and the old ones that have to travel so many. And there is one thing that we would like to do away with is really yung mga fixers. Pag ayaw nilang maniwala, then we'll just have to arrest them and give them a lecture somewhere else. Diyan na nakakaano. LTO is one. Yung Land Registration Commission is one. Grabe dyan. Walang papel, walang ano, kung ano-anong kaputahan ang any excuse. Tsaka pera-pera dyan. And I really do not know, but they are revising the entire map ng ano. Yan, bit matrabaho yan. Yung reconstitution, yung mga ulol na yan. Yan. How can you reconstitute ng Davao on by one person? Yung mga spurious documents na binibigyan ng mga, there was a judge, but he was already ousted. Yung mag-reconstitution ka. So eventually, I could not. Sinulatan ko Supreme Court, sabi ko, inutol itong judge na to. Sabi ko. And he was ousted. So yung mga ano, yung online gambling must stop. It has opened a lot of avenues for many people to just do gamble. It's out of control sa pagkor. So nandito ma, si ma'am dito, si Miss Domingo. She has to, I would suggest that sometime soon, iputuloy niya lahat yung licenses na binigay niya sa mga ano. Kung sa saanan lang nag-sprout, in Davao, they're at it, but I stopped it on time. Mahirap ang puro sugal na lang ang nalaman itong, and there's no way of government collecting taxes there, online. Well, how do you collect the taxes? Well, not only the, not exactly the taxes, but I do not want a proliferation of gambling activities all over the country. Mahirap yan. No, itong, this is just my native idea. I don't know if it would jive with, ano. Kung magawa na lang tayo ng daan sa art, si Art Tugade, yung isang bagong daan na papuntang Pampanga solely for the road and other allied services but mainly for the road access to Pampanga Airport para doon na lang yung ibang flights sa domestic. If we can have just a road and until we can have the new whatever doon na lang muna sa Pampanga ang ibang ano para hindi mag-clog dito because of the talagang traffic. The best day, in the meantime is, I said, one road network that would be geared towards Pampanga and Clark para magamit natin. Yun na lang muna siguro. I really do not know if we have the money to build a new airport dyan sa Sangli to extend it or Kung mayroong mga bagong ano, papasok na may pera, di sige. Wala tayong problema dyan. But in the meantime, we have to remedy the overcrowded skies of Naya. Isang airport lang talaga tayo. It's Naya, period. And it services the entire country. And all of the planes going to Manila are landing there. So how do you expect... Kaya umiikot ng umiikot. And the danger, maubusan ka ng kagaya ko. Halos, we had to have an SOS. Well, I was low on gas. And I was only good for 17 minutes. Sabi ko, mabuti, pinalanding kami. Kaya ayaw ko yung may special treatment. Walang ano-ano dyan, stopping of the activity just because somebody coming in. And also, next time, itong mga APEC, pati should be there somewhere where we do not really. The least inconvenience and disturbance to the people should be better. But itong ano, meron akong isang suggestion lang. Itong, we do not share commonality in all of the aspects of governance. So we can have the cluster. Si Jess, mausay dito, kay matagal ka dito eh. Kung clustering na lang tayo. So you might want to talk to Attorney Medial Dia. Kasi sayang ang panahon ng iba eh. You can work better. Tapos patawag mo dito, wala namang... only those departments that are interconnected with their duties. Parang may germane ano kayo. Pero yung iba, hindi mo kailangan. We can have a good governance and anti-corruption. Basta yung good governance lang, take out the, I do not want an anti-corruption. Basta ayaw natin ang corruption, period. So good governance, economic development, human development, and poverty reduction, climate change, adaption and mitigation, security, justice, and peace. Yung kita nga sa, ulitin ko, yung kita ni sa PAGCOR, it runs into billions. The last time I taken notice of it was 35 billion, something or 30. It will be geared for health services. Kasi ang even the complaints yan sa mga PGHs, mga doctors, is that they have to shell out, contribute sila just to put the patient to buy the medicines. I think that these billions, if just nakatutok yan sa health services, would go a long way really to provide relief to almost every Filipino. Yan lang, hindi makabili ng medisina. Hindi naman kasi lahat. That's why I'm sending Secretary Ubial to Cuba. So kung sinong gustong pumunta, that's something to do with you know, human welfare. They have a good practice there. And if you guys want to go there, you can go and I will allow you. Meron tayo lang magandang paraan ang Cuba. That's why it was a socialist country working very well. And over time, hindi nga na nakuha. And it, because the people were contented and happy. And they had perfected a welfare system for all. Na baka makopya natin sa ano. Especially yung ano nila. But you should be happy to know that I said they have found the source. Yung PAGCOR, nakatutok lang sa medisina sa lahat ng tao. So kung sino yung may, ano, hindi po, meron ako yung lingap sa mahirap. It hits about, mag-abot, minsan there was a time, inabot ako ng 280 million. Pero kung ito yung para talaga sa tao, yung walang sabing walang medisina, ang masakit, kasi ang tao pag walang maibili ng medisina, patay. Simple, pagbigay ng resita ng doktor, tapos sabihin ng butika, magkano yan, ma'am? At ito, gastusin, no, mag-abot 1,000. Huwag na lang. So, medyo masakit pakinggan yan, pero that is the reality on the ground. I hope that this PAGCOR thing
total kita naman niya ng sugal. Itutok ko lang dyan and would look for something else. I am not ready to. It has something to do with the betterment of our country. But it is a geopolitical. Alam niyo kung ano yan. Geopolitical matter which I have to discuss with the Security, Justice and Peace Committee. We have to make up our minds. But we can also prepare the people kung where do we go. I'm referring itong sa arbitral judgment ng sa korte. Maybe after we expect it to come July 16, 12, and after that we can discuss what steps we will take along that line. Dito, it's a, ano tayo dito, cliffhanger tayo kasi if we decide right, we might also find some alleviation in some of the problems here. Eh, nga naman kung sinubrahan natin, it should be a soft landing for everybody. Na kung mayroon man, we do not really taunt or flaunt it, soft landing lang tayo dyan. And we will study progressively kung paano natin magamit ng, of course, it would be a moral victory and put a country at in an awkward position. But then again, I said we have to go into the reality sa buhay natin, if we know, you know, lalo na sa atin. We did a lot of many things, hardware and all. Since we have to solve some of the problems that would involve violence. Ako, I do not want it. God knows I really do not want to declare any fighting with anybody. And if we can have peace by just talking, I would be very happy. So if there's anything more that you guys would want to take up with this meeting, you're free to. Okay, po, ma'am.